Alright, so hello and welcome everyone again for the second time today, and this time it's gonna be Heroes Chronicles Revolt of the Beastmasters. We don't have to wait for any kind of matchmaking here. Gonna be continuing with the last mission of the campaign, as we have finished with 7 already. Gonna be down the first Tatalian war already. It's actually not a small mission, as I thought. It's gonna be actually a medium one. So a bit larger map, so it could be taking us like 2 hours maybe. Maybe in slightly more, and Prince Niven joined Tarnum to free both the Madlanders and Erathia from Mad King Gryphonheart's brutal reign. So yeah, that's exactly what we have been working for the whole duration of the campaign here. And what we're gonna be getting as a bonus. Probably the Lizard Warriors, since I'm thinking we're gonna be starting with... Maybe we could be starting with both. Gonna be curious if it's gonna be like an ally, as an ally, or if you're gonna be controlling both our Tarnum and also Prince Niven, gonna guess. Well, yeah, well, I'm gonna see with the Lizard Warriors, I guess, first. Just so that we follow up with the morale.
Erathia had crowned Niven the new king of Erathia, leaving King Gryphonheart without any support. The Mad King would be at his most dangerous, now that he had nothing to lose.
I met briefly with Niven when I arrived in this region. He had grown a moustache. This reminds me of the Orville episode right about now with Bortus. Since I last saw him. Probably an attempt to make himself appear a little older. He was, after all, a young king. Droglo rode next to him, still dressed in his mud-stained leather tunic. A few smudges of dirt and the angry pink scar on his jaw marred his otherwise perfect face. Droglo couldn't grow a moustache if he spent the next 3 years trying. He would always look young when standing next to his friend. Well, I guess I should call you king now, I said, taking Niven's hand. It's only a title, Tarnum, Niven said. As much as he wanted to continue joking, to keep this pleasant moment alive, we had serious work ahead of us. Your father's armies are in the south. Unfortunately, we took heavy losses driving him there and need to rebuild our forces, I said. Niven nodded his understanding. I've taken some losses of my own. When he first arrived, we suffered heavy losses to ambushes from the natives of these swamps. I tried to reason with them, but they would not believe we were allies until Droglo convinced them to stop their attacks, Niven stated. So, we're both having trouble. The only good news is your father has lost his support from home. He is alone, except for the thieves and mercenaries he's been hiring. Are you prepared to keep this war going until he is defeated? Absolutely, I have sworn it, King Niven said. So there we are. Apparently we are gonna be then controlling both. Yeah, can't see Niven is gonna be there. Tarnum on the right side, getting the archers, and if you go getting the crossbowmen, it will be most probably actually for Niven. Alright. So don't have to rely on any kind of friendlies and everything. And he's like, what the freaking hell? He's really level 32? That's even more than Tarnum. Yeah, we weren't able to actually level up that far. But we have quite solid stats as opposed to him. So he's level 32. He has all of these things. But he's just this crappy, because he wasn't in any kind of extra buildings and skill points and skill nodes as we were with Tarnum before. You can see how much of a difference it actually makes. He's not gonna be that strong then. Okay, so you do have that because you have specialty of Ballista, because you are using the hero Sir Christian. You have plenty of money. We'll just buy everything. And he is upgraded, so we should be able to get some kind of good battles here. We'll probably head into the right side and we're gonna be having even some extra army. The few dudes will want to be added into our party. Can we already get in Wyverns on first day? Thank you. Alright, so probably that we definitely need the Dragonfly so that we are gonna be playing first. We can probably keep the archers here, like the Weaklings armies. You're gonna be strong enough, maybe giving them some other hero, we'll see. But at 50 at the same spot, that seems to be a bit more than is needed. Let's split them over into 25 apiece. And let's see if they want to join. Actually, no. They want to fight. That's not kind of good. Because that means we also need to be looking at those guys. And you can just collect. Everywhere throng of gnolls, like what the hell. Yeah, I cannot exactly take it on with those heroes. This one especially, because he's kind of weakling. Maybe with her, with Andra we could, because she's having good spells. She's a quite a competent spellcaster. So she probably can take it on. But this dude, certainly not. A lot of them everywhere. This is like kinda on steroids, the whole mission apparently. All the monsters are having like 2 tiers numbers more than they usually do on the start of the mission. It's really kinda strange. And it's gonna be plenty of resources for Tazar to be picking up. Thank you for the skill check and pendant of free will. Well, nothing all that important. And maybe you could send her on the right side. And yeah, because Tazar is gonna be following through after Tarnum and just picking things up. And she can definitely handle a few battles herself. Alright, but here at the bottom it's gonna be getting a bit more funny. So shall we head through bottom or a bit more to the top? I'm gonna be looking a bit more here. Aha! Dragonfly Hive, can we take it on? But it kinda depends. If it's gonna be the big one, probably way too many losses. So I'm just gonna be heading to the bottom, get the Archer's Tower for a few more archers. Seems like an idea. And there's a town. Cool. And much more importantly this. Yeah, we're taking you guys on because we need a gold mine. Absolutely, certainly. So are we gonna be clumping up somehow? For example, aiming for the lizard warriors. Ah, yeah, they could. Apparently, I'm in here. A bit more, probably for the first 8 tent, I would be expecting. So, 400. Yeah, exactly. I can play just wait for the archers to do some honors. With those skill points, it's probably not gonna be all that hard a mission. Alright, so do we do with you? Do we have Chain Lightning, for example? Apparently not. We don't apparently have even like Inferno. So it may be getting slightly annoying. Frost Ring. Can we cast it behind you? Apparently not. Therefore, Fireball. Thank you. Okay, so fireball is 15. Frosting should be a bit cheaper because you do have upgrade on that. But yet again, it's kind of stupidly positioned, so we have to waste mana, unfortunately. But looking how we are having 400, probably won't be mattering too much. Let's see if they are actually able to clump slightly better, so that we can kill them faster. Maybe they can. Well, if they didn't get extra morale, obviously. Can you imagine Inferno here? Holy damn, that would be something. Exact 100 is there of them, apparently, to begin with. What are actually guarding here? That's gonna be something big, I assume. Can we get that this turn? I don't think so. We could have won it, but yeah, well, that's one turn. Doesn't really matter too much. And how many opponents do we actually have in this game? One. Okay, it's gonna be only the Mad King Gryphonheart. Alright, this could be getting slightly tricky. We don't have mass slow. Luckily, you don't actually need to run away too much. But it won't really matter too much at this point. 240. I was looking at the frost ring. That's not enough, so it has to be with your shower on the triple. Yeah, 240. So how's it looking with the magic arrow? 210. 8 for lightning. And ice bolt is gonna be good enough. 380. So what kind of treasure are we gonna be seeing here? Because they definitely would have been guarding something good. Apparently a lot of resources so far. Maybe there's gonna be some kind of artifact on the left. And Basilisk picked. Okay, so we are almost finished here. The last one, the Hydras, you're probably not gonna be getting that easy and that quickly as Mage Guild, and we definitely do want Monastery before the end of the week. Unfortunately for them, they don't have any kind of shooting castle, so they're just gonna be tempted to go outside and just get very easily destroyed and slaughtered. As Astrosy, I know, but it doesn't work for Heroes Chronicles. Heroes Chronicles cannot use it. So I have to play it like this. I even have to use monitor capture because you cannot start it in window mode, unfortunately, on Windows 10. So yeah, this is the real old school experience. I know full well that there is an HD mod and it's an absolutely godsend thing. I of course play the original, or rather the standard Heroes 3 with it as well. Yeah, no, but it's not the same because you don't get cutscenes, you don't get everything else, you just basically get the missions. So that's kind of boring. I want to be playing the whole experience as it was created and meant to be. But definitely thanks for the tips, because they are quite interesting to somebody who wants to be experiencing it that way. It's not really any kind of problem. I mean, like, even if I use the HD mod, I don't really play on the biggest resolution, because everything is just way too small and it's just not fun to play that way. At least for me. For others, I guess that it might be. So I really don't have a problem playing on this kind of resolution. Wyvern's Nest is kinda getting expensive slightly, since we're not making all that much money. Well, we do have quite a strong hero, so I don't exactly think that we're gonna be losing this mission anyway. So, can I guess, let's just do it. And we're gonna find the money somewhere along the way. And by the way, when we're talking, have you actually tried the conversion of Heroes of Might and Magic 2 into Heroes of Might and Magic 3 engine, the Succession Wars mod? I already played that. Oh, ambush. Would you look at that? Oh, that's not much of an ambush for the army that I have. It's absolutely really great. The combination of Heroes 2 and Heroes 3. The graphics of Heroes 2 and the factions and everything in Heroes 3, basically quality of life changes. It's absolutely awesome. Definitely recommend that. I have a video in the past broadcast here and I was streaming it. And I have also one on my YouTube with the links. I think I have the link in the past broadcast video description as well here. It's from like beginning of January, because I right now cannot recall the exact link how it is. But it's on mod database as well, so ModDB, you can find it there. It's Heroes of Might and Magic 3 The Succession Wars, it's called. So far they haven't ported the campaigns yet, they are working on it as far as I know. But it's already quite well playable for normal missions. So, it's really pretty great. It's kind of nice breath of fresh air, if maybe you want something a bit different from Heroes of Might and Magic 3 and after HOTA and the other expansion that right now I cannot exactly recall. So, if you want something new for Heroes of Might and Magic 3, definitely there are options. 250, well, we don't have enough from that. I'm kinda curious if at least the last hero is gonna be kinda strong, but I kinda think that I'm playing this game, or rather these missions in the Heroes Chronicles, in a way that the developers didn't exactly expect. I'm kinda completionist, so I try at every turn and every mission to collect everything that I can, every skill check and skill point, which results into this at the end, which usually isn't something that they can handle, the heroes and enemies that are waiting for me at the end. I'm basically playing it also for the missions, and when I'm trying to complete everything, build every city and stuff, it also allows me to be getting all the extra turns and therefore all the extra pieces of the story to be displayed. So in that way I'm basically getting a full story than if I was just rushing through it. And it's actually, they put quite a lot of work into it, considering that it was a bit of a Hail Mary back then, when 3DO was already bankrupting. So kind of a bit of a shame that it wasn't enough for them to save the company, because they did make pretty great games, not only of course Heroes, but also Might and Magic as the RPG itself. I also play it on the difficulty, on the base difficulty. I'm not even increasing it into impossible and stuff, because when I play these games for the first time, and I actually haven't finished the Heroes Chronicles before, so this is like my first playthrough of those, even though I finished like Restoration of Erathia like 5 times maybe, Armageddon's Blade Shadow of Death as well. So I want to basically experience it as the developers designed it and how they meant it. So today we captured some rogues when they tried to ambush our supply wagons. When we searched them, however, we discovered a note bearing Mad King Gryphonheart's royal seal. "It's a bounty on the head of his own son, Niven," I said aloud. "How much?" asked Karamina, who was always at my side these days, perhaps to make sure I didn't make any decisions without the consent of the wise women. "Twice as much as he has offered for my head, 20,000 gold." "Well, that's not much." "King Niven must have really angered him," Adamina said. "Yeah," I said, crumpling the paper, "and if I know anything about Gryphonheart, he'll do anything to get his way." Turning to the nearest soldier, I said, "Hurry, get me out of fastest runner." I do have a feeling that actually we're not gonna be connected here, and Red is gonna be having some brutal army against Niven on the right flank. We'll see, I guess. So far, you can find below the stream basically the order in which I'm playing it. This is the third one. I have played Warlords of the Wasteland, that was the first one. Then I have played Conquest of the Underworld. Right now, this is the third one, the Revolt of the Beastmasters. So basically following Tarnum, even though he's probably in all of them, I would be expecting somehow. Or maybe this is the last one, not entirely certain, but anyway. This is my third one, and I kind of enjoy the story because I basically embark on the quest of getting the whole history and lore behind Erathia and Enroth. These games are the first one in line. And they definitely do fill quite interesting spots in basically the knowledge that I was missing from playing only Might and Magic 6, 7, 8, 9 and the Heroes 3, 4, 2 and 1 of course. But 2 and 1 I haven't finished either, because I was too small back then, around 2k, and before 2k rather, to finish with them, so I'm also looking forward to them. I play them a lot, but obviously at that point I just didn't know English well enough to be having any kind of idea of actually what's going on. This is gonna be a bit of a novelty for me as well, those stories when I get to those. So Stronghold, that was the first one. That was Warlords of the Wasteland. That was pretty solid. That was pretty good, yeah. Great Ignore's Flail, that's quite a nice boon. I mean, like, seriously, you make this kind of hero, you don't give him even, like, logistics or pathfinding. That's gonna be so annoying to play with him on marshland. Yeah, Clash of the Dragons, that I think is a bit further down the line for me. Or the Erathia and Enroth story mode. So it's gonna be still waiting for me. I haven't played that yet. And the Sword of Frost, that's gonna be also a bit later. But definitely looking forward to those, especially the Sword of Frost, to be honest. That's gonna be an interesting one. The Jelu campaign or Jelu? Gelu or Jelu? I'm not entirely right now certain how it's actually pronounced. Probably depends how, however anybody wants to be pronouncing it. It was a bit unexpected ending to that campaign there. And the sundering of the worlds. Okay, so in the end we are connected, so there's at least something. I don't think that I have actually done portal in this one. Because they were stingy and they didn't give it the whole campaign. I'm kind of thinking that actually it is on purpose on those Green Rose Chronicles. I'm absolutely certain that in the first one it was on purpose, because the only way to get that was from one, I think it was a pyramid, from one pyramid in one of the missions. And I actually messed it up because I didn't have enough wisdom for that. And you cannot get it twice. And since I don't want to basically reload and kind of want to live and play with what I get and with what kind of mistakes I potentially do. Yeah, well, the whole campaign without town portal. Luckily, it's not impossibly difficult. As opposed to, for example, the Stedvik mission. There is a quite the brutality. I never could finish it otherwise than basically tricking the AI on leaving the town and taking it unguarded by having some artifact on me in combination with logistics. That's one hell of a mission. I really wonder if it's even possible to beat it without the cheese. I would assume that maybe so, but it has to be like... I've never had any kind of idea how to do it differently. I got on portal, if I remember properly, in the previous campaign, in Conquest of the Underworld. I think I did it somewhere at the very end. It definitely seems to be restricted, especially at the starting missions. Because I always finish all the times and all the mage guilds and everything. I never got it there. And right now I'm at the last mission here, and I still don't have it. And I have finished all the times to the fullest. All the towns. But I kind of think that it's a nice design, because it's making it at least slightly challenging, and I think it's also to make it so that you spend more time in the game and get more pieces of the story. I think it's gonna be also part of that design. Okay, 11 at 66. They could be clumping up. They have a pond in the middle. Let's see. And it's gonna be good enough for frosting. I kinda like it more this way. I mean, from the year from all the years that I'm actually playing the game, I basically already know how far they can go. Sometimes I make a mistake by a hex or one or two. But usually I don't, so it's already kinda in my head, and I know how far away they will be going. So I kinda wing it slightly. Because I don't like to have in the grid there. Definitely know that it's quite useful, especially in PvP I probably would be playing with it. Because there you don't really want to be affording any kind of mistake like that. But against an AI... yeah, I don't think it matters too much. So I'm just gonna be enjoying the full graphics. Let's get a few more griffins. One of the greatest units in the game, and for you, I guess serpent flies, just a few of them. You're not making enough money, but there's still enough treasure. And as I said, we don't really need the army yet, so we can afford it. Just get as many units as we can for a bit later, if we even need it later. Okay, so how is it looking here? Should we split something somewhere? We have the Wyvern, so we don't need the extra spot for them. Ah, well, screw it. Okay, it's gonna be the bigger version. It's gonna be at least a lot of Wyverns. Infernalsham Wayfarer. That does ring a certain bell. Is it actually in the original version of Heroes 3 Complete? Because I have finished all the missions in Heroes 3 Complete. That was a bit of a thing that I had a few years back, that I wanted to finish all the missions that were designed by the designers. So if it's in there, then I did finish it, but cannot really recall it right now. $220, that should be enough, right? Oh well, just barely, $240. Ah, that's just a bit annoying. Yeah, they're just gonna be surrounding somebody. And let's wait for frosting. Okay, so if it's a fun main map, then I have most probably not played it. I haven't played all that many of those. Because, for example, I haven't played all that much of Hota, for example, either. I have just kind of dabbled in it. Though haven't exactly grown a liking. So I'm thinking, though, that I will definitely try it and finish with some of the campaigns and stuff, because it's quite nice community work and everything. And I definitely appreciate those. But I kind of really enjoyed the original game, because I'm really long time with it. I have played it since the very beginning. So it's also part of my experience from the childhood, so a bit of nostalgia is there as well, influencing what I play and how I play the game. Okay, so it's gonna be some kind of XL map and really hard. Okay, that seems interesting. So good for... thanks for the tip. That's a good idea maybe to try. Could have maybe done it without any kind of losses using Resurrection, but yeah, well, let's not bother with that, I guess, here. Yeah, 300 still. There are lots of greater basilisks. They could be thinking that we are strong enough, so they could be... only in 3 clumps. Or maybe not. Alright. Or is it actually the other way around? If they think that I'm weak, they're gonna be having more. And if they think that I'm having strong guys, then they're gonna be in fewer ones. Yeah, that makes more sense. That's probably gonna be it. Probably switch it around. $500, that's gonna be a bit too much. $200, that's what we need. So boys, you could be clumping a bit better. You have a lot of obstacles there, so don't get extra morale. Yeah, okay, thanks, Astosi. I switched it around. It definitely makes more sense this way. Why did I even stop there? Because they couldn't get through. Yeah, he has blocked himself, so he's not even gonna be moving. I mean, like, I could so use an Inferno here. Yet again, spell I didn't get for the whole campaign. Holy crap. It's so annoying. But anyway, it's looking like a Frostring then. I mean, like, we could slow them all. Well, with this one, apparently not. Yeah, I forgot. Tarnum has the Earth Magic at Expert. So we probably should be getting rid of you. That's gonna be 200. That should be enough for Stenero. and those are gonna be destroyed next turn. So let's just probably move all the way to the top at this point, or maybe after they move. If they go through the bottom, yeah, it's gonna be better. Let's not lure them to the top too quickly. Apparently somebody is not listening. Greater Basilisk. Two at the bottom. It shouldn't be reaching. Shouldn't be reaching yet. Yep. Okay, so it's gonna be him. He shouldn't be reaching either. Yeah, that's working so far quite fine. And he does, but nothing that he could have done about it. Good night, Zastl Sidem. Yeah, well, Age of Mythology, that's gonna be more on Wednesday at 18 GMT, the standard community games. Definitely gonna be streaming then, and well, over the weekend, not entirely certain, because the tournament has finished. There's nothing lined up just now, so I'm thinking it might be just the Wednesday sessions for a bit. But I know the tournament is coming up, going to be hosted by RTS League. And that's gonna be streamed there, not on this channel, it's gonna be at twitch.tv/RTSLeague, but it's gonna be coming about like 2 weeks, I think the first matches, 2 or 3 weeks the first matches could be happening. It's gonna be clan tournament. So yeah, more Age of Mythology certainly is coming. So thank you for the company today, and see you later. Okay, so we are at the second week, therefore let's head into money. Right, this is slightly different, because this guy is not exactly that strong. He is basically higher level than Tarnum, 32. Tarnum is 27, but the stats, that's all we have collected in the 7 missions on all the skill nodes. And obviously, he hasn't been there himself. Well, he does have Ballista, that's actually really good, with Expert Artillery. That's gonna be like 200 damage per hit, maybe. So basically 400. Why the hell he has expert magic, I have no idea. But okay, I guess. Ah well, let's do it. Let's not be cowards. They're gonna figure it out somehow. The army is gonna be surviving. I was just thinking about not receiving too many losses. But anyway. Okay, let's hide them behind there. Need to move ahead or not? I'm not entirely certain if they're gonna fit. Let's do this. You go ahead. Okay, of course. Absolutely nothing there. Expert fire magic, and they don't give us even any kind of spells. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm gonna be actually killing those through the other guys. We'll just start with those. Well, I've moved already. I can plug it by the Griffin, because he's gonna be faster. Yeah, let's do it. Now, that was a nice hit, the second one. Of course, that definitely has to be some kind of magic in the first item. The AI definitely loves that. Some catnip for basilisks or for other units as well. Or maybe they're just going after the drugs, after the morphine. Could be. The thing is, who is actually abusing the tent? Is it me abusing the AI, or is the AI trying to abuse the tent for something? But yeah, that's really kind of weird quirk. The same as they definitely do like to be going for the ammo card. Even though basically the effect of the ammo, you need to be having a very long battle for it to be actually important. So it's really kind of strange priority. For the ballista, you can definitely understand it. But for the others, well, not so much. I mean, like, the tent can be really good if you have first aid on expert. It's actually not bad at all. But kind of would be thinking that it's a bit more stronger, rather a whole lot stronger in PvP rather than PvE. Okay, so they have actually grown quite a bit. They do have something in the middle. They could be clumping slightly more favorably. Yet again, Inferno. Please, Inferno, that would be so sweet. Okay, this is a slightly different story. Yeah, I won't be able to deal with behemoths, seven behemoths, one after the other. That I cannot do, unfortunately. Yeah, well, that will have to wait. Yeah, did we get so much wood and stone? Didn't even notice that. <laughs> 167 wood. Maybe one of the starting ones was actually a bit increased. Sometimes happens. And I just didn't notice, because that's a really unusual number, even for all the treasure that we have found. Mine, that's what we want. And for free, not even any kind of effort is necessary. Several Chaos Hydras, that could be, yeah, that could be a whole squad as well. Like, one by one. That's also something we cannot deal with. But, we're gonna be getting magic. Magic bag, as we have already kind of depleted. 968. It might be even enough for the whole duration of the game at this point. Well, fortunately we don't have good spells for you, so you're gonna be surviving a bit longer. And do we even bother leveling you up? Because there's no point, this is gonna be the last mission, so I think maybe not even. So let's just head to the bottom, because you're gonna be opening this way, through the rocks. A few interesting artifacts, looking at the one on the left. Immunity against lightning bolts. Okay, well, that's gonna be a whole lot better now. And there is Rhett. We have found him. He's gonna be hiding in the corner here, all together. He can even cheat at this point slightly, as he do have view air, view earth. Which one is better? View earth, probably. So, castle there, this doesn't seem like a castle, but could be. Is he gonna be really having so many castles? It's possible. There is definitely one here. No, it looks like, looks like two and third here. Because of the stone and wood. Yeah, it's gonna be having three castles, it seems. Echo frogs. If there's gonna be a thunderbird, then that's gonna be bad. So rather not. We're probably gonna be heading back, buy some kind of army for her. So that she can deal with the behemoths and everything. Could probably build the Glyphs of Fear so that you can get the Cage of Warlords. Since we're heading here with a hero, might be getting extra defense, why not? I'll just save the money so that you can get the City Horse. Oh, now that's a nice one. Thank you very much. That's gonna be certainly helpful, especially for Niven, because he doesn't have logistics or pathfinding. It's actually really good. Thank you, game. I wonder if that was even scripted. Hello, Mr. Castellatus. So, could we see view air is location of unclaimed artifacts? Yeah, that's the one. He's having so far two towns. The third one could be probably even taken by us, as we are right next to it. Okay, we need to just defeat him. Yeah, let's say hello. $280. It's not enough, Frostring is not gonna be enough, Meteor Shower is way overkill. But for 12 mana, who wouldn't buy it? Those boars there, pack of boars. Well, it's not gonna be shooting either. It's only a fort, not even a citadel. That should be fairly simple for Sir Niven, the King of Erathia. Right, so maybe you could even get stables. Have you actually visited the stables with him? I kinda guess that he might have. There was somewhere here. Or did I remember wrong? I probably did. Yeah, I probably did. But anyway, that could be kinda helpful. Allowing him to move a bit faster. Let's just do that. I can't be right now in even joining. Yeah, that's definitely scripted, as we had this scripted at the very start on the right town. But unfortunately, the computer just didn't engage with them, and so he didn't get the free units. Oh, well, thank you very much then. Well, that's something that actually the designs didn't account for. Okay, so we said that we're gonna be getting the extra defense and some kind of army for him. We are at day 6, so I guess you might just as well wait for the last day. No reason why not to. And let's buy something cheap. Basic diplomacy. Well, definitely wouldn't be all that happy if that happened somewhere earlier and this was an important hero. But since that is not the case, well, all the more power to you. Kinda thinking we might not even need to right now save the archers, but just so that we don't fall out of habit, let's do it. Alright, well, that was simple enough for us. So I'm still kinda waiting where we're gonna be finding him. Since we do have actually this border guard, I'm kinda thinking he might be locked behind it. So like the last castle is gonna be behind exactly that. Well, in that case, let's gather the money and have a look if that is exactly what's going on here. Thank you. so it's gonna be Capitol, right before we're gonna be finishing up. The week number two, so we are still basically like 3 weeks in. And we haven't really met any kind of significant opposition yet, and here we can just build a citadel to get a few more units. We are out of money, but we could be quite successfully selling a lot of wood and stone. Let's just do that and get 17,000 right there. There is Mr. Hero. Just as I suspected, Mad King Gryphonheart sent an assassin after his own son. I received word from Niven this morning that someone recently tried to kill him, and if not for the messenger I sent to warn him, the assassin might have succeeded. The killer came in the middle of the night, disguised as a monk loyal to Niven's cause. By the time he slipped into Niven's tent, Drogol had already spotted him. As Niven described it, the monk drew a long blade from the folds of his robes, but before he could attack, Drogol jumped on the killer's back and dragged him into the ground. Rather through ground. There was a brief struggle ending with the assassin's death. That definitely does sound like the guys that actually joined us a bit before. With Tarnum, those dudes. And that's only Cuthbert, so we can go back to him. Just to make sure he doesn't try to retake any kind of mines behind us. And all kinds of nonsense like these. And you'll be getting more units. So what do we give you? And what do we improve for you? So I'm kind of thinking we should be improving the Serpent Fly so that we play first no matter what. It's always a good idea. And I'm kind of thinking that might be even it. Because we really need to be continuing building everything everywhere. Just so that we don't spend more time on this mission that is necessarily needed. But I also want to be finishing all the towns. We just try to play it kind of optimally. We definitely need to switch them or rather split them. As it would be a bit of a waste of resources and everything. And now, are you strong enough to deal with the behemoths? Pack of behemoths. That could be like 50 maybe. If they split, that's gonna be 2 per bunch. If I had actually mass slow, that could be working. But otherwise, might be getting slightly interesting, but we at least do have good stats. So I think you're gonna survive it. Let's see. Probably gonna be right now stopping for the luck at least. That is even way behind. There probably was some kind of treasure hidden there. That reminds me of the very first campaign, that was Warlords of the Wasteland. There is one mission where there is in basically this kind of position on the map, hidden a gold behind a mountain, and it basically gives you like infinite gold, like a huge amount. And I'm not really certain if it's supposed to be doing that, or if it's just basically some kind of bug. That it was positioned somewhere where it shouldn't be, and therefore it's resulting into some kind of program overflow. And therefore it gives you an insane amount of gold. Could be. Definitely one that remains to be seen. But it was definitely quite a bit of a surprise when I actually happened upon it. Okay, let's give this a whirl. 3-3, that's actually a whole lot better. So they're apparently at least a bit apprehensive because of the strength of the hero, which is of course gonna be helping us quite a bit. 3 times 300 is of course 900, so I'm thinking we're just gonna soften them up slightly with the meteor shower for 525. No! Has to be getting lucky. Cool, guys. We're gonna be eating those to death, and the ones to the bottom we're gonna try to destroy. That's 480. Is Lightning Bolt up to it? Ice Bolt is slightly not. Lightning Bolt should be. Yep, it is. There we go. Gonna be getting the Border Guard, and next stop, several Chaos Hydras. It should be even easier, I'm thinking. He actually cannot take this on. I'll be liking so, but he is definitely not strong enough for that. Well, they have split, but we have plenty of hit points and plenty of defense, so it shouldn't be that bad. That's gonna be 500, which should be exactly for Meteor Shower. Again? Really? Well, right now there's not much of a point actually attacking because you'll be damaging all of them. We need to run away first. Now we can. It seems that at this point we are making enough money to be able to basically build in every town on every turn. So it seems that we are kind of heading towards the closure quite a lot faster than I actually thought. I was thinking that this mission might be a bit more challenging, but yeah, we still kind of don't know what's actually gonna be hidden with the last hero. So, oh well, ambush, probably nothing all that major, yeah. So maybe there's still gonna be something quite nasty waiting for us. It will take a bit of effort to deal with. Probably don't even need to do anything here. That spell power is slightly annoying. That's gonna be probably costing us a few lives. Yeah, well, what can we do? 300, and that's, this is like 500. Slightly above. Now, let's try to spread it out. I don't know what spells he has. Probably nothing all that important. It's maybe gonna be like only Lightning Bolt, or maybe not even that. But still, you kinda never know. Or maybe he doesn't have any spells even. Maybe he really doesn't. Maybe he didn't even get a single spell. Well, he didn't have actually Mage Guild, if I remember correctly, in the town whence he came. So it's not entirely impossible. So therefore, yeah, well, tough luck with Bert. That is 780. That's actually quite a bit. But Lightning Bolt is gonna be, of course, resolving that no problem. And give me all your knowledge. Yeah. 24, 24, 22, and 21. That's how you like it. And even extra gold is gonna be coming into our coffers very soon. I'm gonna be left at literally one gold. We are rich. We are so rich. Okay, so who are you? It's gonna be Ingham. I'm thinking that actually the main hero is gonna be still standing there. You can see the flag. So I think it's gonna be the King Gryphonheart. Waiting for his chance. And just basically waiting if really that is going to be an opportunity to attack one of our heroes. Which I don't think is going to be exactly the case with how it is so far going. Okay, so that seems to be everything covered on the left. Right now there was this. Yeah, we need to be going for a few wyverns, but we're going to need to free up space. Therefore it's going to be, of course, up to Tazar to be taking probably the rogues. And basic estates, they are giving him all kinds of extra skills that he doesn't exactly need at this point, but yeah, well, at least he's gonna be clever and smart and charming. Okay, that is at the bottom. So Ingham apparently is trying to be annoying, but well, Tarnum is gonna be exactly heading his way at this point. So he should be probably getting scared well enough as, oh well, bit of a little ambush again. Definitely quite brave guys in those numbers trying to ambush this. And this kind of hero, 37-38. Well, cannot deny the bravery. That is definitely certain. Okay, give me the rogues, the same or other dress you can keep, no problem. Just gonna be heading here for more extra wyverns, and is this gonna be enough for you to even take a bit of fights against the gnolls, for example? 121, I think that actually you can do it with 16 and 18, should be fine. Let's have a look, but first you're gonna be heading into the temple just to give you at least a bit of a boost there. So look at the griffins. $170, that could be enough, and it certainly is. Alright. There we are as well. It's gonna be one dead, no problem. What is certainly gonna be a bit of a problem here in this mission, and since we have two castles so far, maybe even three, yeah, we actually have three castles, is definitely gonna be Portal of Glory. As that one is gonna be hard to get because of the whole a lot of resources needed for that, and we don't exactly have too many mines. Extra Vibrants are home. Nice. Okay, so where is the Mistred? Through bottom. Let's try to right now scare him a bit. He's gonna be running away so that we can control him and let Tazar deal with all the rest. Since it's the 7th day, and we're gonna be getting a few more extra soldiers, gonna make sense more than the Citadel or the Resource Hill to just be making barracks for a few new types, but we also should be kinda careful because we are gonna be heading into a situation where we have plenty of soldiers available, and therefore Plague is gonna be coming up as well, as we are also a bit later into the game. Today, Drogol, representing Tatalia, and Niven, representing Erathia, signed a treaty stating that no man, woman, or creature can hold another as slave. Niven has a difficult task ahead of him, restructuring Erathia's economy now that he's freed all the slaves, but I think the boy is up to the task. Perhaps this bold agreement will spread to other nations as well. Alright, this might be a bit fun. Because here again, we still don't have any kind of spells whatsoever. Let's move the griffins through bottom here as well, so that we can potentially like put them into defensive stance. Of course, AI stand fetish definitely working for us. That was nice double hit. And you can right now still attack, so therefore you can probably clear the single. So that he doesn't waste anything, and let's just go back with you then. It's kind of unfortunate, but nothing too bad. Okay, so Mr. Ingham, you're gonna be next in line. How do we deal with you? 160, but you're gonna be even playing first with Lizard Warriors. But yeah, let's just make sure of all of that, and yeah, well, he's gonna be just running. What a coward! And holy damn, 30 griffins here. At least you're gonna be getting a few more angels than only one. Alright, so that's gonna be 750. That's really quite a bit. Let's wait how they're gonna be attacking. But I also want to be also attacking them for lowering their attack. To happen, and then, well, we're gonna see. Those are definitely dead lizard men. Not much I can do about that. And at least we do have some kind of favorable position here that you can use the meteor shower on them. Yep, certainly helpful, and we cannot fly anywhere too much. And we are still very much healthy, so we should be able to survive that. And we can right now probably use a bit of a resurrection. Probably not on those guys, but maybe maybe so. Okay, let's do it. Just for the fun of it. But apparently we don't have... with this hero we don't actually have expert resurrection. So they're not gonna be staying anyway. Yeah, well, that was just a random plan. Apparently not gonna be working too much. Let's just finish this. And accept the losses. And the gain of 3 angels on top of that. Not a bad trade at all. They actually want to fight still. Well, they can have a reason for that, because that's 40 that's 40 basilisks, so that is definitely a decent reason to be wanting to fight. Unfortunately for them, of course, our hero is way stronger than they probably counted for. And we might just as well right now start with the assault. 320. Fireball, not enough. That means that Frostnik is not gonna be strong enough either, but Meteor Shower certainly is. Don't want to be exactly risking getting morale bonus and kinda wrecking the archers too much. Sorry. Holy damn. Yeah, I forgot that I'm not right now with the other hero, but with Tarnum, and therefore that's brutal attack from him. 400 damage per hit, so basically 800 damage by the ballista. That is definitely something else. Oh, they actually want to join, and I don't have a room for them. Ah, well, that's disappointment. And in that case, I just basically don't want to be dismissing anybody else. Who I already have in retinue, so I'm just gonna be having to pass on the Mighty Gorgons. Yeah, well, quite a bit of shame, but not like it matters here in this mission. But I should be probably really keeping at least one open spot. Okay, so can you take this on? Yes, you can. With the skill points that you are having, you should be fine. Get those 60 rogues. And a bit of spells on top of that. Okay, 160. Go. You can right now keep this open so that the other heroes can collect it. As heroes seem to be heading towards like a bit of an endgame here in this mission. They're definitely closing in on the opponent there. And it's also gonna be about when we can finish with all our buildings in the town. That's gonna be taken a bit because really, especially those last portals of glory. Now that's gonna be a bit problematic. Looking at the amount of resources I have. And of course finishing with all those mage guilds might be getting tricky as well. I'm right now getting slightly, ever so slightly worried. Because he might be in range of the hero, and if he's somehow insanely strong, then he could be trying to attack Tarnum. And even though Tarnum is insanely strong himself, there's no guarantee that he won't be even more insanely strong, but, you know. So kind of tempted to basically just make sure we don't do something too bad, and therefore just having some kind of save. I think it's something that we're gonna do. Can I just finish building up the towns now? And then we will try to somehow secure the safe in case something really unexpected happens. Okay, so there we go. So he's gonna be right now here, safe. Let's load the game into autosave. Save it into the second. And right now we should be covered then. Okay, so let's have a look at him. Oh yeah, he does have... Okay, so you cannot move anywhere. All Gryphon... this is actually a picture of Roland. From Heroes of Might and Magic 3. That's kinda sick. Because he's actually the good guy. He's not the Mad King Gryphonheart. But, yeah, well, no reason why he shouldn't be looking the same as his ancestors. So, kinda guess. Of course, makes sense in that way. And he's having, what, 300? Basically, this we can take on right about now with this. Looking at the stats and, of course, the strength that we have overall. So we can take this on. The basic question is going to be, how do we want to roleplay it? If we will want to be having Tarnum deal with that, or if he should be leaving Niven to deal with it. Actually, thinking I'm gonna be leaving it up to Niven for roleplaying purposes, kinda making sense to me. Okay, so that's 240. I think that's a bit short. Oh, it's actually right now already enough. Yeah, we have improved our skills for the tier actually in the Library of Enlightenment. So that's probably gonna be the reason why we are right now up there with the damage. Can right now build at least one. Alright, so we are at least starting. But we don't have much to sell. You can see those gems are definitely gonna be needed. And all of it is gonna be needed because of all the mage guilds that we are still to build also. But yeah, well, slowly we're getting there. I ask Drogo to rejoin my army now that we are getting closer to defeating Mad King Gryphonheart. It's good to have the boy around again. There are still a few things I want to teach him before I have to leave, and as long as he's at my side, I can protect him from harm. Drogo doesn't know it yet, but he's the future of Tatalia. If these creatures of the swamp are ever going to build a nation, they'll need a strong leader. 34, that's about like 200. Oof, you don't have exactly enough damage for that, but let's just at least begin. Okay, so that's gonna be leaving us only with the Hydras there. And looking at the money, you might even be starting to buy something, because you're gonna be having plenty of it still for even the Portals of Glory, so let's just buy plenty of sulfur here. Oh, well, that's a bit less, so that we have something to build for even. This is probably gonna be collected by Andra already. Let's head back. Oh, ambush, really? Let's head back to the left, potentially wait for army here, and then we're gonna be attacking the King Gryphonheart. This is looking nice. Alright, that seems to be about it for the whole corner of the map. Just the darkness right now is gonna be remaining. We captured. And they apparently won't be even wanting to fight too much. Yeah, with all the wyverns that we have collected, the angels and stuff. Can't exactly blame them. Okay, 20. That we cannot exactly afford now. And there's not much of a rush, considering we have to build plenty of buildings in the other towns first. So, yeah, I think that's it here. Don't really think there's anything left for us to capture, therefore we can be heading home, Tazar. Rather, it's Niven. Oh, well, I thought it actually Tazar. Well, then, Niven, you can be heading a bit different home, like there. Ah, damn it. To get the army so that you can finish the mission then. After everything is gonna be built, as there is a bit of an ambush here again. Not much of a problem. And 30, there is 300. That's gonna be up to Ice Bolt. Okay, so you are Tazar, so therefore you can go home. I was just kinda waiting if there's gonna be a town portal in the last mission, at a time where we don't need it at all, because for the whole game it has been restricted. Blind has been restricted as well, to a pretty good degree if I remember correctly. That is something that we have learned in this mission and maybe in some of the previous ones as well, but I don't actually think that too much. So maybe it was also only in this mission. Not entirely positive at this point. I think that basically all the important tactical spells weren't available. Last building belonging to the enemy is there. Let's pick up a few Wyverns. There's actually gonna be quite a few Wyverns. It should be like the 8 of them, if I remember correctly. Okay, so 240, that's gonna be enough for the magic arrow, and let's just start with the top ones. Weakening us already. And 8 extra Vibrance, definitely quite a good trait. Okay, we are right now starting to grow up on the money, so we'll just buy a few more. Add a bit more sulfur, and we apparently also need mercury. Both quite low. We're gonna be needing plenty of those still. Not only for the Portals of Glory and the Mage Guilds, but also for the Ponds for Hydras. Let's leave it up to the friend. And finally, King Niven is gonna be learning some new spells. He has been, curiously enough, given by the designer's expert fire magic, but he actually hasn't been given wisdom and not even a mage book. the spell book. Enjoy your spells, Your Majesty. Doesn't really matter with this hero what you're gonna be using, because Ice Bolt is usually cheaper, but since we do have Expert Air Magic, it's the same cost, so we don't even need to turn the page. Let's attack through the bottom. Combine it with this guy. This is gonna be up to the Ballista. Okay, let's finish with the Hydra Pond here. So that's gonna be first town finished. It's gonna be Marsh Choke, our capital. Already everything done it. Right now we're gonna be waiting for the Portal of Glory here. And on the other places, still a lot of things remaining. Okay, this is gonna be waiting for the Hydra Pond as well. And nothing else is needed. Hmm, 29. Yeah, well, if he weren't such a competent spellcaster, that might have been slightly scary. Okay, it's 700. Almost for the full lightning bolt here. I mean, like, can we optimize it slightly? We could blind him, but that's annoying. Just probably gonna be going for the damage. Like, why not? We don't have archangels or anything, so we cannot even clone properly. So let's just start with this then. And shall we sacrifice the dragonflies? Because they would be targeted by all of them. We can attack there. Second can attack here. I mean, that like seems like a plan. And now we do have archangels. Alright, so that seems to be pretty much it here. So you can be sent into some kind of other swamp town, which is the other one to the bottom. And this one is finished then, and let's look through them. And you can probably even use a bit of wood and stone, because we don't need that too much. Or anything else at this point. It should be fine to use it this way. And Tarnum, well, you can just basically right now camp through bottom. You're not gonna be even fighting, but you definitely should be close through final battle of this whole campaign. Okay, we need 6, I think, for this. No, we need even 8 already. Okay, so we can sell one more. One more there and one more here. Now the fourth level of the Mage Guild. And still no Time Portal, but at least Chain Lightning, which is something that I could have used as well in the previous course of the whole campaign. Yeah, well, not exactly what was allowed. And break camp. Is he even gonna be getting some reinforcements? Because he seems to be basically still the same. He hasn't even moved into the town. And the town is getting, of course, all the growth and everything. Seems to be not fully upgraded yet, but it's of course capital, so he's getting plenty of money from that. And since basically the end of the mission is... it's actually finishing hero. Alright, so we don't even need to defeat all the enemies. So you won't be fighting the castle. You'll be fighting only him. Yeah, well, that's gonna be simple enough. A fire set by Gryphonheart's rogues spread through most of the camp last night. Thankfully, no one was killed. There were, however, numerous injuries and several of our supply wagons burned up as well. Well, the most annoying is definitely the crystal and, much more importantly, the mercury. Apparently we should have lost 4 mercury as well, but we didn't have even that, so... kinda saved a bit there. So we're out of the last ones. Might just as well buy all of it. Because you're gonna be needing plenty. So it's one finished here. That means that Claxton is finished the same as Marsh Choke. And we need 20 sulfur. 20 sulfur. Alright, you can probably right now trade a lot of wood. Do we need wood? Yes, we need. We do need 10 wood for this. For 30, like that. No, into this. Which means the Deadwood is the third finished town. It's gonna be 3 out of 5, and here we are gonna be waiting for a portal, and here at the bottom, still for the Mage Guild as well. But it's gonna have to wait a bit. It's gonna be 2 here. Let's see if we can pull it off at this turn. Through only resources. So far it doesn't seem so. Not having enough stone for that, I guess. Be 3 there, and we don't have enough for the crystals yet. But still, you can at least finish with it. And no Tarn portal either. So basically the whole game, the whole campaign, no Tarn portal. Even in the last mission, I was thinking that maybe they could have let up on those restrictions. But nope, they did not. Okay, so basically right now we need two Portals of Glory, which is insane amount of resources. Gonna be 40 of all, and the gold is fine. But the other resources are definitely a problem. But at least we're gonna be getting more of the story. And so you're gonna be spending more time in the game. Gryphonheart has been using our own tactics against us, ambushing our column as we march through the swamp. Today, they came close to killing me. A crossbow bolt hit me in the shoulder before we even knew we were under attack, a few inches slower and it would have pierced my heart. Droglo saw me slump in the saddle and shouted, "Ambush!" And then he charged the ambushers. That was the only way to break an ambush. Charge directly at them. After initial shock, I snapped off the shaft of the arrow in case the head was barbed and chased after Droglo to make sure the boy didn't get into trouble. I came to the spot where most of the rogues had been killed, but there was no sign of Droglo. To one of the gnolls, I demanded, "Where is Droglo?" He went running off after one of them who escaped. "He was plenty mad," the gnoll said. I raced off after a foolish boy. What did he think he was doing? What if he ran right into another trap? Droglo should know better. But there was no trap. I find Droglo standing over the body of the leader of the bandits. He didn't seem to notice my approach. Instead, he just stared off into a nearby mound of vegetation. I drew my sword in case Droglo had spotted another enemy, but when I realized what the boy was looking at, I nearly dropped it. I looked around at the swamp, spotting the signs that we were standing in the middle of what had once been a busy town. Abandoned for who knows how many years, nature had reclaimed the land. But what I thought had been a mound turned out to be the cracked head and torso of a giant statue of a man. It had fallen on its side. Vines hugged it tightly like a dying child. Droglo turned slowly to stare at me. "It's you!" "Yes," I said. Okay. That's quite a reveal for Droglo. It's actually quite a nice idea from the storytelling standpoint. There might be a bit more conversation in the next turns. Well, he's still gonna be here for a bit, so looking forward to that continuation. Yeah, alright, next turn. "Let me explain," I said, entering Drogo's tent. The boy hadn't said a word to me since we saw the statue yesterday. I knew he had asked Aramina about the statue, and perhaps about the past as well. How much did Droglo know? Did he know that the barbarian tyrant once dominated this land and its people? Did he know that, in his arrogance, the barbarian tyrant had statues of himself erected all over the continent? Did he know that I had been the barbarian tyrant? "Explain?" Droglo asked. "Can you explain why you have the face of the tyrant? I don't see how. You can't be the tyrant, he's been dead for a very long time, so it must be coincidence, right?" I could tell by the tears in Drogo's eyes that he didn't believe his own words. "That's right," I said. If Droglo didn't want to talk about it, I had to accept that, but he deserved some kind of explanation. I asked, "If a man, a king, made many terrible mistakes, do you think he should have the chance to redeem himself?" "Depends on the man, I think," Droglo said. "Take Mad King Gryphonheart, for instance. His crimes are too great. He deserves only to rot in a pit for all eternity." "If only the boy knew Gryphonheart's crimes were nothing compared to my own." Exactly was going to say that. "Well, if that man got the chance to make things right, he would probably look for someone who was nothing like he used to be, someone fair and good, to take over when he was gone. I left the tent knowing that this revolt would be over soon, and I would never see Droglo again. But I smiled. Erathia was in good hands with Niven as their king, and Droglo would protect the people of Tatalia for as long as he lived. And one day soon, the statue of the barbarian tyrant would vanish into the swamp forever. Finally, the wounds of old will have a chance to heal." Nice storytelling. Okay, so let's do something about the portals, because right now we have plenty of money. It's gonna be 8 there and 8 here. And we are kind of out of money, just basically. Build in one, so we can probably wait a few days, stockpile it, and then build one right after the other. And let's also use at this point the other resources. So So that is gonna be another town down. It's gonna be High Castle, and we are waiting for the last one. And we don't need those resources anymore. Therefore, we can change everything and exchange everything. 7, 21, 9 there, 13. I don't think I have enough because it's costing a lot of gold. Now we should be having enough. Okay, I'm gonna be waiting for the last one, right? Kinda curious if the next week is gonna be actually the plague. We are not at the end of the month yet, so I think it could be good on that regard. But still, it might be getting slightly annoying if that were to happen, because we need Niven to be actually fighting the battle. He does have plenty of units here, but if everything just got halved, might be getting slightly challenging, but probably not too much. Probably not too much. We will need another town anyway, or other turn. Let's just wait, and right now let's buy it. Three there, it's gonna be full. Two here, and let's buy it up. Which means that even Castellatus is gonna be finished, so let's just check again. I really like to be having everything done before we finish a mission in a campaign. And it seems that we are exactly done. Alright, so let's just buy some kind of army for Mr. Niven and get going. I don't think he needs anything all that important and big. But maybe let's wait like a turn, buy all the angels, and then just basically shower King Gryphonheart with Divine Wrath. Seems like a plan. Of course, those are gonna be slightly challenging getting all the gems. Getting two, and I mean, like, Griffins could be good enough for all of that. They are incredibly strong. But I guess another turn couldn't hurt. And then we're probably gonna head out. Because he's not entirely too strong. We have visions, as we do. He's having 5 normal angels, 80 griffins is like the scariest thing there. 11, 14 are not bad stats, considering that actually Niven is not that much better. So probably could be using a few more angels than in the end. Because I want him to be taking the fight. I don't want to fight with Tarnum. It would be really easy. You just walk in the park. But I want, for storytelling reasons, to be having a fight between the kings. The former king and the new king. Yeah, let's wait for the next one. Alright. Give me your angels. And we'll still need him 15. Well, 13, therefore. That's exactly nice. Can just buy a few archers to finish it up. I'm gonna be buying everything. This should be definitely plenty enough. Let's split those into two. 82. And let's have some fun with Mr. Almost forgot actually the last piece of the gold here. Okay, we haven't been here, so we can even pick up the extra ore hiding behind the mountain. And get in the extra luck and morale. Let's go this up. Alright, so he's gonna be having a few flyers, so probably we should be hiding at least the archers and the zealots somewhere at the back. Of the griffins front, another one to the bottom, and angels can stay in the middle. Well, you do have some kind of spells, but or other spell points, but you might not have all the spells. Yes, he's gonna be definitely quite nice blind. The vault is not that bad either. I'm thinking that blind on those archerinos is actually gonna be useful. Definitely didn't do as much damage as I thought that they could be. Yeah, the defense skill is definitely not bad. Okay, yeah, block there. We are gonna be right now using this to, of course, attack the griffins. We need to be getting rid of the rogues. Which we did. See the retaliation here. Maybe he's gonna be even able to kill that. Apparently not. Let's be done with it. That was definitely a waste. And I cannot right now activate you yet. Right now I can. It's gonna be at least softening you up quite significantly. We have already cast spell this turn, alright. And we can right now go into resurrection, so those griffins definitely died. Quite a horrible death there. I just help them ever so slightly and deal with this. Deal with that. Probably move a bit forward to have a look. One last hit. Felt 150 marksmen there. Congratulations, you have completed your quest to defeat the enemy hero Gryphonheart. Victory is yours. That's gonna be the whole end of the whole campaign. So let's save it at 8. Let's see if there's gonna be some kind of cutscene at the end.
Mad King Gryphonheart's army fought to the last man. In all the chaos, Tarnum faced Gryphonheart himself. But although the immortal hero was a far better swordsman, the two leaders dealt each other a mortal blow. That night, before the Tatalians could bury him, Tarnum's body disappeared.
Actually assuming that you're gonna be using the strongest hero there for Tarnum. I'm not exactly expecting that you could be using the Niven. But yeah, well, I'm kind of thinking that Tarnum could have joined us well. He was just waiting beyond the gates as a reinforcement, so yeah. But anyway, that's gonna be the third Heroes Chronicles game finished for me in the Might and Magic story mode round for Erathia and Enroth that I'm going for. Quite fun again. Got rank Crusader here. It's not gonna be orange, it's gonna be black either. And of course you're gonna be to the top, even beat Fafnir, Gretchen, Gundula and Dracon. Yeah, we are so good here. But anyway, that was quite a great campaign yet again. Gonna be of course following through, as you can see below the stream, the list of all the games in the story mode with another Heroes Chronicles next time around. If you're gonna be playing. But yeah, well, that seems to be it for today then. So I hope that you enjoyed. We had a bit of an attempt at Total War Arena before. Didn't exactly work out all that much. So we switched into Heroes Chronicles and we had quite a bit of fun with the last mission here with continuation and kind of finishing the story of how Tatalia came to be. Definitely fills a lot of gaps, at least for me, as far as Might and Magic 7, for example, the story there, which is where we get into Tatalia and Erathia and all the other kingdoms of that land. So yeah, that's gonna be it for today. I hope that you enjoyed. If you're gonna be interested in more, then of course gonna be streaming according to the schedule below. It's gonna be Age of Mythology at 18 GMT on Wednesday. On Thursday at 18 GMT, you're gonna be seeing, maybe I could be attempting and having another shot at the Total War Arena before it closes fully, or it could just be Pillars of Eternity yet again, and or maybe something else, we're gonna see. But on Monday, next Monday, it is gonna be either more Heroes Chronicles, or it could be Back to the Settlers, or maybe even something a bit different, like Transport Tycoon Deluxe. You'll see, something old-schooly, most certainly I would be expecting. But anything can happen, maybe something can be coming up that will spark some interest in me. Yeah, we'll see a bit later. But anyway, thank you for watching. I've been Blackadder at Blackadder's Place, and see you later.